I come from a defense background. My dad was in the army. And I live with my mom. She's 85 years old. So this entire thing started about 2 years back when I moved from, because I wanted to be, as a family, we have not spent a lot of time with our parents, you know. I was in hostel, my brothers were in hostel. Then dad was traveling, so all that was, and when parents were in Hassan, we were in Bangalore. So we did not actually spend a lot of time with our parents. And after that, yeah, we felt that we should spend time with mom and take care of her. So my mom used to go to Canada very often. She used to fly to Canada to live with my brother. After when winters used to set in, she used to come back. So that happened for 5-6 years. So when I was in Bombay, I had this thing of not spending time and working in Bombay, because mom never wanted to come to Bombay. So I said, sure, I should go back. So when I came back, so I was staying with my mom, and one evening while having a bath or something, she fell down and she hurt her head. That time she was 2 years back, so she was 83 years old. And she was rushed to Baptist, because that's where she goes, because why she goes to Baptist, there's another story, because there's one General Shetty, who's an ex-army doctor, who's a her doctor. So she wants only to go to General Shetty, because that's the connection. Because General Shetty has served with my uncle who commanded AFMC Pune. So that connection is that army. So she likes to go there. She's comfortable. Actually, she doesn't want to go to hospital. She says, I want to just that. So we took her to there, and then we were facing challenge at home was, we don't have a lady in the house. Because I'm single, we don't have a lady in the house. So mom was there, and mom, you know, doing things for mom, she's not comfortable, the son is doing it. So I called her, my sister, I said, you better come down, because mom, this is the situation. So my sister came down, she said, we need to find a solution to this. We need to get a caretaker for her who can groom mom, get her medicines right, change her, because she needs it. So we were finding people in Bangalore. We tried, there's a place called Nightingale?
Nightingale.
We tried Nightingale, we spoke to General Shetty, we spoke a lot of contacts, because my sister, we spoke to a whole lot of them. The problem, it was not the money, the problem what we were facing is, the critical part for my mom was the night and early morning. So we need somebody during the day. 24 hours kind of stuff, like a companion for her. So we couldn't find somebody. So word of mouth. We got a girl from Jharkhand, a tribal girl. So she came with a reference. So my sister spoke to her, she trained her to a large extent. And then over the period of time, we interviewed a lot of people. In this time, we interviewed a lot of people from Bangalore. The problem what we were facing, my mom can't speak local language. Her Hindi is okay, but she's more comfortable with English. And then second, she's very particular, she's in bed, but she's very particular how the girl is dressing up. She should be very clean. She's staying in my house. She's going to stay in my house. So we had a lot of these, because 83, you can't handle these situations. Then we could find somebody in Bangalore who could do this. And we got this girl then. The problem, we had to train her. We trained her. Money was good, everything was good. The challenge what I felt in India is people, like he says, we are heading for a grey tsunami. By 2022, India will have 144 million. You'll have a lot of rehab cases, you'll have a lot of post-surgery cases, you'll have a lot of cases which are coming up and they need to be taken care of. In India, in medical, you may be talking about the best of hospitals, but you don't have a single agency nationally where you can call and ask for help for your parents, be it short term or long term. You don't have one. You will, there agencies which exist, they are so much in demand, they'll give you a waiting period. You need to have pre-booked them 3 months in advance. They will find somebody who will need, and you like it or not, you're going to live with it, otherwise they'll just take it. So in India, we are not able to develop these healthcare basic work. The girl who came, we never treated her like a maid. She was my mom's healthcare. We never treated her like a servant. She did only mom's work. She was very happy. whatever money she earned, she was able to send home. Her brothers could, younger brothers could go to school. The other thing that I faced with my mom is what we all face is, 85, she's a child. You know, today I'm here with Anand. I have to make sure that someone's babysitting with my mom and because the girl is gone for the day. So I have to make somebody at home. And today, it's not that I'm doing for my mom. My mom's, the gray tsunami which is hitting India, they are the with very high disposable income. My mom's per year pension is about 7.2. So it's not that she can't take care of us. It's just that she wants to take care of also, we don't have services. And India is heading for this. This is a big market. People should think about it. And there are so many youngsters we can train, we can give them basic education, get into the space because there's nobody doing it. Doctors don't have answers because doctors are doing surgery for every second person. My mom was a recommended surgery at the age of 80 by some doctor in Artinagar because she had a back pain. He said, you better operate it because you guys can afford it. So these kind of cases also come. So it's an opportunity, it's a challenge. What challenge what we faced was, first, we didn't have a lingo. Second, we need somebody to trustworthy with whom we could leave. Third, was, you know, you have to make certain adjustments because we had to buy the girl her own TV. You know, because it's a very stressful job. You've got to think from a person who's helping a senior citizen what she goes through. That girl must be going through hell every day with my mom. But she used to make sure whatever my sister told her, she did that. She gave my mom medicine on time with a smile. She never raised her voice on my mom. So there are people, we can create these kind of job opportunities for me. People who are not educated, but they have a good heart to serve. The girl had a beautiful heart to serve. That's very important in this service. And whoever gets into it, you can make money in this business. But don't think it short term, look at long term. Because a person who's going to take a person from you should also believe in your vision. Never treat these people like servants. We never treated her like servants. She was helpful, she was there. And we treated her fair, and she treated my mom with heart. So there is an opportunity. I always tell Anand, there is a huge opportunity. We all are going to sometime or the other in urban areas we're going to face. Because the problem also, what you're going to face is what I'm facing right now is, whenever my mom, I need to engage her with good discussion to keep her mind, otherwise she's going down. She reads paper, she asks me, "Acha, what is this? What is this?" I need to keep her engaged, otherwise she's going, if you don't keep an elderly person, because you just keep her in one room and one bed and daily routine, because in Bangalore you can't take senior citizen now, you can't take them to a park also. There's no entertainment for them. Only thing is TV, paper, whatever. But if you have parents at your home, please keep them engaged with conversations. Because I started realizing when she's talking to my elder brother in Canada, she's taking my name. And when she's calling me, she's taking his name. Otherwise, she's fine. She's fine. She walks, she does everything. It's just that what I'm saying is, people in this age need to be taken care of like a child. If your parents, you know how to bring up a child, something like that. Because we all are going to face this.
You also want to talk about your NGO.
NGO, there's no point right now, we're still working on it, but we are getting this space in the next 3-4 months, we'll be out. I work also, the NGO which I've started, I also work in the people who are disabled, challenged. So I'm working in that space. This is my personal, this is my business which I'm working on, disability space. So that, Anand and me are working on it. So in the next 3 months, we should be out. So there's a lot. We can do lots, we can do. The other thing I've noticed is for my mom, now she doesn't have family. She doesn't have friends also. Same is with my aunt, who's also 85 years old. She's in Canada, she gets 3 pensions, and every 6 months she's flying out of Canada. She's also single. both her daughters are settled in Canada. But she gets three pensions. She's also independent. But every 3 months, my aunt is dancing around in Israel, or she's in Hong Kong, or she's in Macau. She's sending pictures, and she's able to use WhatsApp and all that. But she gets so should. But your mom is done. She should move to Canada with me, because mom can't do. She can't hold a phone also. But this one is dancing around in Macau, playing casino. She's saying, I'm doing my own money, my kids are settled. That's the difference what I've seen. And that, I asked my aunt, I said, why do you do it? She says, son, it's just that I'm only acting. That's the difference I've seen. Like what Anand says, there's a difference between Indians and... But they also have a very good support system. Like she just fell down, she also broke her leg, knee. She slipped on the ice and she fell down. But she got entire treatment at home. She was cast. Because their social healthcare system is very good. Today you call a doctor, he's stuck in some traffic jam, you can't blame him. He's stuck in Makri Circle, he said, what to do, sir? I'll come after 2 hours. No, I don't have my driver. So there are the issues. As a country, as people, we need to work around these solutions. And I feel there is a good force which we can train for building. Basic things. You have to have a good heart to serve somebody. You don't have to do a nursing degree. Half of our nurses are dumb. I work with them. I know. They don't know how to take a blood also. When I was running a healthcare staff, I knew half of the nurses are not moving blood. They don't know how to move blood. They give it 5-6 pricks, yeah, from here, 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 they do, and they do it for the kids also the same thing. So there's no point in getting a workforce which has a nursing background or something. You can create a force, treat them well, because that's what people need. They just need good people to treat them. Like my mom, she doesn't need, the person should be well enough to treat her, that's it. You have to have a good heart, that's it. To be in this place, you have to have a good heart. No degrees can change that. So
for companies trying to identify staff, right, if somebody is looking to set up some kind of services in this sector, how do they select staff? Because
selection of staff, so you will not get people from Bangalore. I'm telling you, if you are a startup, you are advertise for a 10,000 rupees sales job, also nobody will come and say, no, I'm not going to do this. You have to get people from who are hungry for good opportunity, get it from rural area, you get those people. Bangalore, you don't get a driver, I'm telling you.
Start with Skill India.
You don't get a driver. You advertise for a driver, you don't get a driver.
It's not just Bangalore. The reason I asked is for geriatric care, a person needs to have a particular mindset. They have to be pleasant, they should not get irritable. They should want to spend
all the other skills you can train them. All the other skills you can train them. But this is what it is. And I'm telling you why I looked at people. This girl came from Jharkhand. What I find is people from villages are very humble. They're not corrupt. Like when we went Hassan, we had help there. Hassan also, we had a lot of good people. But Bangalore, I can find a decent servant for my house. That's the difference.
Maybe I want to rephrase the question that he's asking. So, if you're looking for any qualification, you can find it by having.
You can, there's no qualification.
But in this case, it is difficult to identify a person who is kind hearted or good with people.
Well, there are actually agencies who are starting a business. See, actually, whatever you think is a problem, that's also an opportunity. There are people who have started business also. They are giving training on caregiving itself.
They validate the society.
So if you think that's a problem, make note of all the problem we talked about, that's how the business can actually. And this is a problem, there are people also doing it, but there are.
See, first thing in Indian houses, what we have is our parents facing, why are you bringing some stranger into my house? So you have these issues in those letters. I told mom, we don't have so much of gold that she's going to run away with it. By the whole thing, they're paying into what will she run away with it.
How many startups are there in that space?
In this space?
Yeah.
Who knows, somebody is doing it, Bombay, somebody is doing it, but they are very expensive. Yeah. They are only catering to the cream of the cream. General public, they can't.
What we have raised,
they are only doing it, you know,
Oh, there are quite a few. In fact, few of the hospitals in Bangalore also have a division which does.
Manipal has
it. Manipal has
it. I met the first geriatric doctor in Manipal. Portia.com, they raised $76 million.
Lot of people are doing it.
My only thing is, lot of people are doing it, but they are doing it for
people
who can afford it.
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Can you pay $25,000?
No.
For a person to do this? I couldn't. We paid a only driver.
But
what I'm saying, there are companies doing it, but they are doing it for the people who stay in defense colony of Indira Nagar for that.
Exactly.
What about us? Yeah. I don't have a bungalow in defense colony.
Right.
Yeah. Right. So there is an opportunity. Don't cater only for one. What I'm saying, there is an opportunity for everybody. Because everybody's parents needs care. Yeah. Today, India has become a dual income household. Husband, wife are working. Right? You don't mind paying $15,000 to take care of your parents, but you can't pay $30,000. Yeah.
You will pay $30,000 for a EMI for a bigger car.
So, sir, recently, Nightingale, they have a daycare center for old age people, for all lower middle class. Okay? They send the bus, bring all the old people.
I'll tell you, I faced a thing in Goa.
Recently, last time I visited.
No, I had this. The problem in India is when you send, a couple or a family, they send their parent to old age. Neighbors, there is a social system.
No, this is not old age.
It's a recreation center.
Shanta, around 100 people, around about 670. Every day the bus goes, picks them up, they make paper bags. We went from
some kind of activity.
And they're so lively there. They keep them occupied, and this can be a social reach.
This can be,
and it is very important because, as you said, a lot of people can't pay 15,000.
There is some money on CSR.
Yes, and from CSR they are getting funds from Tata Sangha, and they make these paper bags. They ask if you can give us all the old papers, we'll make bags and sell it to outcomes near Lal Park. So this is one of the initiatives. And anybody interested, it's a huge opportunity.
There is, like, oh, there. There is an opportunity.